coming today. This is a very big occasion for Scott Township, finally getting our deck hockey rink open for business. Commissioner Bruckner, our president of the board, was unable to make it today. However, he did want me to say that he is working on getting some banners for around the hockey rink. He is trying to get some donations for that. And I think he already has a couple already in place, ready to go. With that being said, I wanted to turn this over to Eileen Myers, the Parks and Recreation Chair, to talk a little bit more about the project.
Thank you for coming. We don't have a speaker, so I'm going to try and be as loud as I can. In attendance with me is Commissioner Tom Costello, Commissioner Dave Calabria Sr., Commissioner Dave Calabria II, and Paul Aver. So I just want to make sure you guys know we're all here. I just wanted to introduce a couple people here that have been very instrumental in making this rink possible. It's a beautiful rink. I don't think we have any other one around here that's as big and as beautiful as this one, but I'm a little partial. I want to thank Kathy Frankel, first and foremost, from DCNR. She's the regional advisor, and without her, this would not be possible. So, Kathy, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. Kathy got us grants totaling $413,200, and it wasn't just for this, it was for our beautiful playground at the top of the hill. I'm sure everybody here has seen that. And in attendance with us is from Senator Toomey's office. I'm sorry if I get this name wrong, Mike Terizio. Mike. Representing Dan Miller's office is Noah.
That's Noah.
State Representative Anita Cooley. John Howe, representing Lennon Smith and Solaray, oversaw the whole project. And we have a guest speaker with us tonight. Our guest speaker has started his career in 1982 to the year 2000. He played for the Pittsburgh Penguins from 1983 to 1992. He is a two-time Stanley Cup winner with the Pens. He is currently the color court commentator for the Penguins radio broadcast. In his NHL career, he has appeared in 477 games, scored 88 goals, 111 assists, and also appeared in 56 playoff games where he scored 13 goals and 12 assists. He is lovingly known to his Penguin fans as the Old Two Niner. We are excited to have him with us today to celebrate our grand opening of this beautiful duck hockey, and it's my pleasure and my honor to introduce to you Mr. Phil Bourne.
Woo!
Real long-winded. I came to the Penguins in 1982. I remember like it was yesterday. I borrowed my mom's 1978 Mercury Cougar, and I was not drafted. I was basically an invite to training camp. It was in Johnstown. I remember driving through the Squirrel Hill Tunnel like it was yesterday. That skyline. You've all driven through it hundreds of times, right? And I swear it was, what's that, 36 years ago? And I just had this overwhelming kind of rush of emotion of like, this is home. And I didn't have a contract, I didn't have anything. It was just an invite to training camp. The scout actually said to me, almost word for word, he said, Phil, I can't offer you a contract. I'll give you a little bit of meal money, a couple nights in a hotel, see what you can do. And I ended up getting the contract. I didn't start right away in Pittsburgh, but I'll tell you this much. What makes me so proud to be a Pittsburgher now, and I was born in Boston, before I go any further, I can feel your beady eyeballs on top of me right now. I just want to make one thing crystal clear, that I hate the New England Patriots. I hate Tom Brady. Okay? And I'm a Pittsburgh. I really do. I feel like I'm born here. My mom, God love her, she's 78 years old, still works. She still lives back in Boston. Really the only family I have back there. I very rarely go back there because I feel like this is home for me. And I realized as soon as I made the Penguins as a player, very quickly I realized, and really led by Mario Lemieux, and now it's Sidney Crosby's really taken the torch But when you're a Pittsburgh Penguin, it's more than just being a player. It's more than just being an athlete and having this cool job and everybody patting you on the back and saying, oh, Borky, you're great. Oh, you're a Pittsburgh Penguin. It's way, way more than that. And a lot of it has to do with moments like this, and moments like having a deck hockey rink like this. Because part of being a Pittsburgh Penguin, and I think it, I'm safe to say, it's carried over to the players from this 17-18 season. I'm sure you guys hear about all the things they do. Children's Hospital, all the things they do in the community. And some teams do it, but I don't think anybody does it as good as the Pittsburgh Penguins. Because when you're a Pittsburgh Penguin, it's never written in your contract, but it's understood that you're a part of the community. That you have to embrace the fans, you have to embrace the people that live in this town. And it goes back and forth. And that's a reason why I think a lot of the Steelers, Pirates, and especially Penguins, still live here in Pittsburgh, because they're proud of not only what they accomplished, but they're proud of what this town stands for. So I just want to, on behalf of the Penguins, applaud everybody that had something to do with this, because I'm sure it wasn't, hey, let's build a deck hockey rink and happen like this. I'm sure there was a lot of work, either physical or political or whatever it was. A lot of things had to happen, go right, to have this happen. And just on behalf of the Penguins, on behalf of every current player, every former player, I'm just proud to be a part of it, and the Penguins are proud to be a part of it. So, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, I knew this was top secret, so I didn't want to let the cat out of the bag because I've done that before. So the big surprise is, and I talked to Dave Soltes, who is the head of the Penguins Foundation. I talked to him this morning, and the Penguins have gone above and beyond, and there will be a new scoreboard here.
All right.
I'm not sure where it's going to go, but we've got enough room here where it's going to be absolutely beautiful. And that's what it's going to look like. So
sweet.
Enjoy it, and
awesome.
Let's go.
What I thought we could do to christen the deck hockey rink is, if everyone would like to go in, we have a couple of the deck hockey balls where they would all, we could all line up, and then at the count of three, everyone could just shoot whatever we have into the nets. Does that work?